So friends, last video we talked about two important skills for becoming a successful entrepreneur. One was selling skills, number two, people skills. So people management and sales skills put together, that's what you really need to become a successful entrepreneur. So having done that, the very important part is how to create capital for your startup. So there are various ways actually you can raise capital for your startup. So today what I'm going to discuss is probably there is no one sure shot formula. But the best formula which I have seen with most of the entrepreneurs is, you know, first of all, try to bootstrap. If you are passionate about your idea, if it is scalable, I would suggest don't rush for getting the capital raised in the first place, you know, from outside. Try to bootstrap as much as possible. Have your own resources. Try to find out ways, you know, try to find out how you can carry it forward with your own finances, with your own promoters' finances, or money pooled by the promoters. So try to go as much as possible with your own money, because what will happen is, you know, if in the first phase you just rush to the investors, if they like your idea, first of all, they should like your idea. So if they like your idea, probably in the very beginning, if you're going there, so they may eat up a big chunk of your equity, and which is not a very good proposition. So it's better if you can carry it forward for a while before you rush to the outside investors. So one way is you can have debt, but that may not be very good option if you're not good with, you know, running the finances, particularly if you do not have a good CFO and board. So initially, it's better to not go into debt. Try to have money, as much money as possible from your own resources. If you are good in managing debt, and if you have good gross margins, if you can create profits for yourself, there is no harm for going for debt as well, rather than giving equity to someone outside. Now, having said that, if you do not want debt, and now you are looking for accessing capital from outside, so number one, you can go to family and friends, and that's your inner circle, you know, where people believe you, people can listen to your idea, and then based on that, you know, they can give you some capital, and they may not be very greedy about, you know, having a big equity from you. So first option is to have it from close family or friends. So that's option number one. Once you have utilized that, then second option which you can go for is angel investors. So there are a lot of investors who are around who look at the good ideas, and based on your idea, based on the scalability, based on gross margin, based on passion, based on if they like your pitch. There are several angel network platforms you can go to where there are lot of angel investors who pool their money and then invest into your idea. So you can go for angel investments. Angel investment can help you to expand to a certain level before you really want to go big and raise even bigger capital. And that's where you can go to VCs, you know, venture capital. Now, let me give you little stats, you know. Most of the companies actually fail in raising capital at the right time. Probably their idea is not good enough. Probably their pitch is not good. or investors are not happy with ROI. So only 0.1% of the startups, statistically speaking, are able to get angel money.
So far, we have discussed, you know, you can raise money from family and friends, number one. You can have, number two, angel investors. Number three, you can go to VCs, so venture capital. They will look at your pitch deck, they will look at your scalability, they will look at, you know, so basically they are looking at the best ROI, scalability, and they also want a proper exit clause, you know, clear in their mind. And the fourth option is then, you know, once you go pretty big, you can have private equity. So they invest only huge amounts of money. Now, having said that, these four important ways of raising money, how do you actually raise the money? You have to be very methodical about it. It all depends on what time you really need capital for scaling up. As I said, try to bootstrap as much as possible in the beginning. But when you feel that you now need outside money, you can dilute some part of your equity, and you have to be smart enough, you know, in terms of how much equity you want to give away to angel investor or your VC. You have to be very, very practical about it. Now, I'm giving you a solid tip. If you are seeking money from big investors, or the initial stage you want some angel money to come in, it's better to have somebody who can not only give you money, someone who can also give you advice and mentor you. It's much easier to ask advice rather than ask money. Because once you ask advice from somebody, he kind of comes on your side, you know, he opens up completely. And as you begin your journey with him or her, you know, the investor, so he will become much more closer to you. He will understand you more closely. He will have several sessions. He will guide you on the right path. So possibly ask mentorship and advice. And as you move along, there will be a time when you feel or investor feels that this is the time when we can get into marriage. So for how to exactly go about how much money is to be raised for your startup, I'm going to have another very dedicated video on that track. But so far, today's video, my idea was to share with you what are the options available for raising fund for your startup. Go for it. So raising money is important, but raising money, utilizing it and ensure a steady cash flow out of that, scale your business up from there, that is more important. It's not about you want to raise money, it's all about how you are going to utilize that money for your startup, how you are going to scale it up, how you are going to create more money, how you can create money and clear off your debts. So, along with, you know, the point of raising money, it's also important that when do you want that money, for what purpose do you want that money, and with that money, from point X, what will be the point Y, where you can utilize those funds and reach at that level. Investors want that clear path and predictability and confidence in that.